I had the pleasure to interview the man, the legend, the icon himself, Hugo Martin. And of course, I had to ask the most important question of them all. Do you think Bloodborne is a masterpiece?
100%. I think it's one of the best entertainment experiences I've ever had in my life.
There you have it, brothers. Bloodborne is indeed a masterpiece, confirmed by Hugo Martin. I'm going to be uploading this interview in parts here on YouTube, and I'm going to post the whole raw interview over on Patreon. If you like Doom and want to see the whole interview, subscribe and like this video as well. Thanks for the support and enjoy the video, my friends. One of the few questions that the Ancient Gods Part 2 left unanswered was why the Doomslayer and the Dark Lord look identical. For real, they are basically twins. Look at this. And this is what Hugo had to say. What is exactly a primeval?
I can't say right now. Again, like, we're gonna get into a case here where, like, I'm like, that's almost like you're asking me to describe what's the combat loop like for our next game. You know, like, I it should be something that is written out and properly illustrated for you guys. I'd like to say that it is simply written in the codex that only a primeval can kill a primeval or something greater. And so the Doom guy kills the Dark Lord. So, you know, and then there is a mysterious voice. The point of that voice was, and again, in a bug to the patch, it was changed to the Dark Lord. That was not like that in Chip. So if I wanted that to be the Dark Lord, it would have been the Dark Lord in Chip. Like, you know, I purposely put that there as an indication that there could be something greater, you know, like something more, something beyond. The questions that I'd like to answer in the Illustrated Bible for the Codex for you guys is like, or at least, listen, we have to leave some mystery to things. So I want to be clear. Will we ever answer everything 100%? I think the fun of the lore and the fact that you even care is because when you think about like the Bible, the way it's written, it's open to interpretation. I don't want to be so like specific that there's no...
Yeah, like no room for imagination.
Yeah, exactly. Do you want us to get down to midichlorians? I don't think so. Like, I think you would rather it be maintain some of the mystery, you know? And it's debatable whether or not, you feel like you guys are already being too specific, but like, we have to say something. But like, yeah, I'd like to keep some of the mystery. So it's better that I put it into this illustrated Bible for you guys. It would answer with primevals, like, why do they look alike?
So the reason why the Dark Lord and the Doomslayer are the same and look alike is because they are both primevals. And this confirmation raises up even more questions. God damn it! If the Doomslayer and the Vaad are both primevals, then what exactly is the Father? In the Codex of the Ancient Gods Part 2, the Father is described as a deity, pretty much. A godly figure of less power than a primeval. If that's the case, I wonder how the Father was able to seal the Dark Lord on a life sphere a long time ago if he's not actually a primeval himself and is actually weaker than the Dark Lord. In the Codex of the Ancient Gods Part 1, it is described that only a primeval or something greater is able to kill another primeval. And now that the Doomslayer and the Vaad are both confirmed to be primevals, who is the godlike being that surpasses their power? Hugo alludes to the fact that someone had to have created the Vaad a long time ago, and that he thinks the Vaad is a direct reference to Lucifer from the Bible, an angel that fell from the heavens a long time ago, and that there is really a god in the Doom universe, a god that created the Vaad and eventually sent him to our reality. When the Vaad first appeared, he passed through the void like a sort of portal to, I don't know. Where does this void portal lead to? Is it heaven? Is it something else? I don't know, you make the assumption, my friend. The Doomslayer looks like the Vaad, because he was destined to become like him. It's not that by some luck he became a primeval. He had the Doomslayer, Doom Guy, he had the potential to be a primeval the moment he was born into this world. It was the Slayer's destiny to become the avatar of anger, rage, and wrath. The only thing the Dark Lord and the Seraphim did was unlock that potential by submitting Doom Guy to the Divinity Machine. Doom Guy was the only person in the universe capable of becoming the Slayer. No one else, only him. If the Dark Lord hath never manipulated the Seraphim and the Khan Maker to submitting Doomguy to the Divinity Machine, then the Slayer would have never been born. He brought this demise, his demise, this boogeyman to himself. So, what exactly is a primeval? By what we know now, a primeval is a figure, a godlike being created by the one true god that we haven't seen before in the games, at least. The only primeval that we have seen so far is the Vod and the Doomslayer. Also, apparently all primevals look like this. Absolutely all of them.
Devoth is the alpha of his world. He is essentially, he was the warrior who fought to be the savior of his world, and he lost. I mean, he was able to save what was left of his city. When you go to Amora, that's not hell. That's just this tiny little place in hell, and that's all that's left of what that world once looked like. So it's really pretty tragic. And Doomguy ultimately saves Earth, and he is the savior of Earth, you know, as well. You're both warriors. You both carry the mark of a warrior. I like the fact that, like, at the end, all the symbols that you see around reclaimed Earth, and everybody views you as like this god, you know, this godlike figure. It says it in the broadcast on your ship at the end that, you know, people see the Slayer as a godlike figure in a struggle between good and evil of biblical proportions. Is that this story would kind of be like the Doom Guy fulfilling his destiny, you know, which is hokey to say, but, you know, like, that he was meant for this. And I'm not sure that he was aware of it, but I think Devoth was. I think Devoth knew. He knows who he is. Certainly, he's the more knowledgeable of the two about who they are. But yeah, I think Doom Guy, whether he realizes it or not, ultimately fulfilled his destiny. Like, he is the one who saves Earth. And I love the idea that the whoever makes primevals, or whether or not they're made at all, you know, and where we go with that, that the person who is the leader of this world, Earth, is you know, the fiercest, the strongest. That description of the Dark Lord at the end of Tag 1 is exactly how the Slayer is in Earth. Like, there is an exact parallel. Like, the fiercest among them, because only the strongest could rule and protect them. I added the protection part, is Doomguy. You know, and that is also, and that is what Devoth is in his world. Only he lost. I mean, he got sealed away. So he's like a tragic figure.
Special thanks to all of my Patreon supporters, you guys are awesome, and a huge shout out to all of my chat slayers. InfinityX117, Cole Thompson, Jack Attack Hero, The Buzz Bass, Solidifier, Icon of Sin, Karu Kenshi, Doomslayer471, The Regular Dude, Andrew Drew, Steven Gonzalez, Ali Chancho, Grimmy Dude, Saint Henthor, General Klypto, Unknown User Zero, Awesome Bra, and Florian Hablo. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for supporting me on Patreon. I mean it. If you guys want to join the Patreon page, link is going to be down below in the comments section. A buck or two really goes a long way. I think by tomorrow I'll have the full interview on my Patreon page, so if you want to see that interview, that awesome interview, it's 1.5 hours. All Patreons get big projects early on that page, like at least 2 or 3 days early, so yeah. Patreon page, link is going to be down below. It's okay, Spottins, please let me know what you think about this video down in the comment section, leave a like if you did, and a dislike if you disliked the video, it is completely fine. Honestly, Hugo didn't want to reveal that much stuff because he's legally bound to not to do it, but he still gave us a lot of hints about what we can experience in the next experience or universe of Doom. In the next Doom game, I'm sorry. But anyways, be sure to follow me on all of my social media, Twitter, Twitch, and Instagram. All the links are going to be down below. And have an awesome Tuesday, my friends. Stay awesome, stay safe, stay home, play video games, and GG, well played. Adios, bye.